D-Link's ShareCenter network storage devices, like the DNS-325, offer many great services, but the one in particular that I can't live without is the PhotoCenter add-on. If you're like me and you fill up your camera's memory card every time that you're on vacation, out with friends, or watch your one-year-old attempt to eat breakfast by himself, the PhotoCenter add-on for your ShareCenter is a must-have. The PhotoCenter add-on allows you to share your photos over the web using the Gallery 2 software on your ShareCenter device. It provides a convenient interface for you to create albums, add descriptions, and even access the albums over the web using HTTP so that your family and friends can view the stored photos on your ShareCenter. Plus, unlike other photo sharing websites where you're limited to the number of files or the file size that you can upload, and there may even be a monthly fee, the PhotoCenter add-on is free and allows you to set the rules. Plus, the ShareCenter allows you to do much, much more, like backup important documents and files, and stream movies and music to your TV. So let's jump right in and I'll show you how to set up the PhotoCenter on your ShareCenter device. Your router is in charge of keeping your internet-enabled devices safely away from outside access. But if you're running PhotoCenter and you want to be able to access and share your photos when you're away from home, you'll need to open up a port in your firewall and point port 80 to your ShareCenter device. So log into your router and click on Status and look for the IP address of your ShareCenter device. As you can see here, our DNS-325, its IP address is 192.168.0.100, but yours might be different. Either way, you'll want to remember this because we'll need it in just a minute. Now, click on Advanced at the top, and you'll be taken to the virtual server list. This is where we will forward port 80 for HTTP to your NAS. Click on Application Name and select HTTP. Click the left arrows and it will auto-populate the port. Below that, under IP, enter the IP address of your device. Ours was 192.168.0.100. And check the box to enable the new virtual server before clicking on Save Settings. Now that you've forwarded the HTTP port 80 to your ShareCenter, you'll want to set up dynamic DNS that will allow you to create a friendly host name as opposed to a random IP address that points to your home or office. Plus, dynamic DNS will update your home's always-changing IP address because most of us don't have a static IP. D-Link offers one of the many services for free dynamic DNS accounts, but you can easily set one up in a couple of minutes by going to dlinkdns.com. And if you want step-by-step instructions on how to set up a dynamic DNS account, be sure to watch our other videos. But after setting up a dynamic DNS account, log into your ShareCenter device and click on Management. Then Network Management and click on Dynamic DNS on the left. Click Enable and enter your account information below. You can use a drop-down to auto-select the server address for many common dynamic DNS services. Then enter the hostname you created through your dynamic DNS service. Ours was dlinktv.dlinkddns.com, but yours will be different. Then enter your username and password for your dynamic DNS account. Click on Save Settings, and after a few short moments, you'll be prompted with the status letting you know your device successfully connected to the Dynamic DNS service. Still logged into your ShareCenter device, click on Applications, and if PhotoCenter is in the Disabled list, you'll need to enable it by going to Management, Application Management, Add-ons on the left, and click on the green button to start your PhotoCenter service. Again, click on Applications at the top. Now you should see PhotoCenter in the Enabled Add-ons section. Click on PhotoCenter and launch the interface. From here, you can add albums, photos, comments, user permissions, and view comments from others. We'll start by adding a new photo album. Click on Add Album on the left navigation, give the album a folder name, a title, a summary of the album, enter a couple useful keywords, add a long description, and finally click Create. The next screen gives you several different setting options like sorting, thumbnail, imagery size, and more. But the default settings will work just fine too. Click on Save to continue. Now we want to add our photos to this album. Click on Add Items on the left navigation. Under File, click Browse, and locate the photo on your computer. You can give the photo a caption if you like as well. You can also have more than two upload fields by clicking on More Upload Boxes. This will give you the ability to add more than two photos at a time. Lastly, click on Add Items. And that's it. You've successfully created a photo album and added photos to it that's viewable from anywhere with an internet connection. Let me show you. From anywhere outside your home or office, open up a web browser on a Mac or PC and type the friendly hostname you created with your Dynamic DNS account and type it into the address bar, adding /gallery2 at the end, and click Enter. As you can see, we have one photo album that we created. If you click on it, you can see the thumbnails of the photos we added. Click on any of the thumbnails to see the full image, and you can even select full resolution for print quality photos. The Photo Center add-on for ShareCenter Network storage devices is a great feature for managing and sharing all of your photos with family and friends, no matter where they are. There's just so much stuff you can do with the ShareCenter Network storage device from D-Link, and the Photo Center add-on is just one of them. And if you want to know how to get more out of your ShareCenter device, like how to back up and stream media, please watch our other videos or make a request in the comments below. Thanks for watching.